Sedgwick Elementary School in Cupertino Union School District has put tools to improve math and reading skills directly into students' hands. The program, called iCan with iPod, Technology for At-Risk Students, harnesses the power of portable technology. The result? Reluctant learners turn into engaged and intrigued students. The program has expanded from 75 students who received pull-out intervention to include 520 pupils campus-wide. Other districts are now implementing a similar program.
I work with students who are at risk, and I pull them out into small groups working on language arts and in math. So I use them a lot. I use them in a way to get the students focused on particular needs that they have, and it's individualized so they can each be working on areas that they need to develop, whether it be multiplication facts or fractions or decimals, or in language arts they can work on grammar.
Normally reluctant learners, these are our struggling students, remember. And learning is hard for many of them. But when you put this device in their hands, it just had a whole different, it opened up a different world and a different approach to their learning that was much more engaging than the pencil paper stuff that they often struggle with.
The program also provides students with access to technology that many have never enjoyed at home. This new experience can reinvigorate a student's desire to learn.
They love it. They see a gadget in their hand that they have used for fun purposes. But here at school, using it for academic purpose, I can clearly see they're highly motivated, excited.
The response has been overwhelmingly positive. The kids are already comfortable using it. I mean, it's amazing the small amount of instruction you have to give to just let them go at it and do it.
That student excitement is also reflected in improved test scores.
They're so excited to use it that they don't even realize that they're practicing skills. So that's what's really amazing about it, is that they just think that they're playing a game. But then we've seen the transfer of knowledge onto weekly spelling tests, chapter tests in the math books, you know, et cetera.
We saw significant gains in both language arts and math. We saw more students moving from basic into proficient or advanced, and that's really what you need to do. Our goal is to always move them up into proficient.
At a school-wide level, when this was just implemented last year, and we did our STAR test for last year, our STAR scores leaped 29 points. Normally, we're really trying to work with getting our kids at the basic and below basic level, get them into the proficient or the advanced level. We moved almost 6% of our students, we moved them from that basic into the proficient or advanced. It is, I think, an indication. It was one of the things that changed last year, and where we put this device into the hands of these children who normally are scoring basic and below basic, and we saw over 5% of the students rise into the proficient and advanced level. That's pretty significant.